this horrible civil war that's happening now began, and a coalition of 10 countries led by Saudi Arabia began a military campaign yesterday. And I woke up one night hearing explosions. I looked out and I thought they were laser beams, but they were anti-aircraft machine guns being shot at Saudi jets. So I'm like, I should probably try to leave now. I tried to, but they bombed both of the airports in Yemen, the civilian airports. And there was no way out. So I thought maybe the US government or our government would help us out. The official response from the State Department was, I'm sorry, we can't help you. We can relay your messages to your loved ones via our website. And I saw other countries like India and Pakistan, China and Russia, taking hundreds of citizens out. So I knew there were ways to get out. And as an American citizen, I felt really abandoned by my country. That's what I did. We had a website, stuckinyemen.org. We were with just like the ACLU and CARE to try to help other Americans stuck there. So I really just wanted to go to this conference. It sounds stupid, though. I was 5 days away from it. Like, in my mind, I thought I was going to somehow going to make it out. For those who don't know, I ended up going to the port of Loka and taking a small fishing boat with my colleagues and crew across the Red Sea to Djibouti, Africa. From there to Kenya, then to Amsterdam. I got the SFO. There was crazy like news. It was a crazy press conference for me to be lawyers organized for me when I landed. And I remember like the next day I would go out to Seattle, made it to the conference. In my Uber going to the conference from the airport, I hear myself all on NPR and BBC, Democracy Now. Like I was on the board before I left, going to the airport, and I was wearing the same jacket for the interview when I landed. And people were kind of looking at me weird, and I was like, well guys, like, hey, and I was like, first of all, I was like shocked he knew where that was. I was like, yeah, yeah. He's like, honey, it's him. And like, I had like 15 seconds of fame on the bar. Cool. In the Uber in Seattle, like, I heard myself on the radio. You know, and I was like, this is crazy. And the Uber driver was like, yeah, this guy's pretty amazing what he's doing, but he's crazy.